What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today we are taking the ThinkSystem SE350 Edge server from Lenovo, and we are actually going to install VMware Hypervisor 7.0. So let's get right into it. All right, so today we are going to take our SE350 and we need to install an operating system. So the first thing that I did was download VMware Hypervisor 7.0. That's the first thing that we need to do. Get that file, download it somewhere. I dropped it inside the desktop and good to go. Now, we need to take that ISO and burn it into a flash drive. I took a flash drive, I plugged it into the machine, and it's the E drive. Good to go. Now, next thing that we need to do is open up a utility that allows us to burn that ISO into the flash drive. Now, I like to use Rufus. And as you can see on the desktop, I have Rufus 3.11. So if you double click on it to open it up, this is what you get. Automatically, Rufus is going to pick my E drive, which is the flash drive. All I need to do is click on select. And all I have to do is locate and select that ISO on the desktop and click on open. Next thing we need to do is click on start. And you get this nice little warning, click yes here. You're going to get this nice little warning that it is going to destroy everything inside that device. Click OK. It's going to start copying and creating the file system within that flash drive. And once it's done, boom, it's going to say ready. All you need to do is close it and open up your file explorer. And there goes our E drive. That E drive is actually our flash drive, which has our VMware bootable files that allows us to boot into the environment to install the operating system. And that's what we are going to do right now.
All right, so we got the flash drive right here. We just finished installing our ESXi 7.0 into the flash drive. Awesome. We are going to insert the flash drive on the front USB of the SE350. See if I could find it right here. There's two of them, so we are actually going to install it right here. Awesome. We're going to turn on the SE350. Power button is right here at the very top where this blinking little button right here. We're going to press it. We're going to power it on. We're going to go inside the X-Clarity controller and configure the boot menu to boot into that so we can start installing our operating system, and then we should be good to go. Awesome. So I'm going to wait here for a while until I see the BMC information on the monitor. And then we're going to head to the lab and continue. All right, so it's up and running. I see my IP address. Let's go over and continue.
Okay, so we inserted the flash drive within the ThinkSystem SE350. We need to find a machine that's part of the same network as that server and type in your IP address of that BMC configuration, which allows you to get into the X-Clarity controller. You're going to provide the username and password. The username, all caps, is user ID. And the password, the default password, is password, all caps, but the O is actually a zero, and hit login. It's going to take you here. And the first thing that we need to do on your left-hand side, we need to click on server configuration. And within here, go to boot options. And within boot options, you're going to see that available devices is a USB storage device, which is what we just inserted on the server. Awesome. We are going to select it and we're going to click on the arrow to move it to your right. Now, before you do anything, we need to move that USB device to the top of the boot order. So go all the way to the bottom, select it, and you're going to click on the up arrow until the USB storage device is the first one on the boot order. Now, the next thing that we need to do is click on restart server immediately, click apply. And then from here, click OK. All right, so we're going to run over to the server. And the reason why is because I do not have a remote console X controller license to actually manage everything on the web portal. So we actually got to go over to the server and press F11 and enter to continue the installation.
All right, so the server already rebooted. I ran over here. And we are just waiting until it boots inside the flash drive. This guy over here. And then we could configure it. Now, typically I would configure the server. I do all the installation within the X-Clarity controller, but to do remote session using the X-Clarity controller, you have to purchase a license. So that's out the question. All right, so it's booting into the flash drive, which is awesome. Super excited about that. We're going to let it load up. Now, on this video, I am actually going to install the operating system on that flash drive. Again, this flash drive was the flash drive that we actually created the bootable drive. And I'm going to take this flash drive and install the operating system on that flash drive. Typically, I do two flash drives, but today, I'm just going to use one flash drive. Once it loads up, I shouldn't have any problems. I did check the VMware compatibility website on the SE350 Edge server from Lenovo, and it was compatible with ESXi 7.0. That is the first thing that you should do. Make sure that the operating system that you're pushing out on your server is compatible. All right, so it finally prompted for me to continue the installation. I'm going to hit enter. So I'm going to hit enter on the keyboard. It wants me to accept the license and agreement. You actually have to press F11 on the keyboard. F11, boom, it is going, it is scanning. Looks like it's going to work. Okay, so we are at the part that it wants me to select a partition or a location of where to install the operating system. I'm actually going to pick this guy right here, which is the SanDisk, and it is the fourth option. And we are going to hit enter to continue. It wants you to confirm the disk selection, so I'm going to hit enter again. And from here, it wants you to pick your keyboard layout, which is US default. I'm going to hit enter. And it is time for me to enter a password. So I'm going to give it a generic password. Once you enter your new password and you confirm it, we are going to hit enter on the keyboard. It's going to prompt you this dialog box to confirm the install. We are going to definitely press F11 to continue. And it is going to install ESXi 7.0 on the 350 from Lenovo. Actually, the SE350 Edge server from Lenovo. All right, so the installation of the ESXi 7.0 within the SE350 is finished, right? Behind the scenes, I added an additional Ethernet cable, which is this guy right here. The red one is actually for the X-Clarity controller. This cable right here will actually allow us to manage our ESXi server. So from the menu, it wants me to hit enter. And it's about to start rebooting the server. All right, so we are back. As you saw, the installation was successful. And the next thing that we need to do is just take the IP address, open up a new browser tab, enter the IP address, and just log into your new VMware hypervisor. As you can see within the boot order, that your USB device is going to change. So this basically means every time your machine restarts, it's going to automatically restart inside that flash drive by default. And that's it, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoy this video. Make sure to hit that thumbs up, smash that subscribe button, and do not forget about hitting that notification bell to get the latest and greatest from this guy. And I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.